Metabolic syndrome is a complex metabolic disease associated with increased risk of cardiovascular disease, obesity, type 2 diabetes, and all-cause mortality. The prevalence of metabolic syndrome in general population is around 30%, and the prevalence increases with age. The characteristic of metabolic syndrome in elderly is a little bit particular compared to the remaining part of the population because usually the elderly people with metabolic syndrome are not really fat or overweight, but they have more visceral fat, and this increases their predisposition to develop systemic inflammation. And this is one of the main causes of morbidity and mortality in elderly people. The unhealthy Western diet and the aging of the population is associated to a global impairment of microbiota composition. This is related to impairment in some cardiometabolic risk factors, and consequently is associated also to the development of metabolic syndrome. Some authors all around the world have tested the efficacy of some strains usually in small patient samples, in order to observe if this kind of supplementation is able to improve the microbiota composition and consequently the level of metabolic syndrome parameters. The preliminary results are usually positive, but they are very limited by the short duration of the limitation, by the testing on very healthy adult subjects and not on ill subjects nor on elderly, and usually also on the very small patient samples that have been enrolled in these trials. In this context, we have carried out a double-blind, randomized, controlled clinical trial on 60 elderly subjects. That have been randomized to be treated with a symbiotics, so a combination of three specific probiotic strains and a prebiotic, in order to evaluate on the short term if their metabolic parameters and their inflammatory parameters could be influenced by this kind of supplementation compared to the treatment with placebo. What we observed is that on the short term there was a global improvement in the most part of the metabolic syndrome components, starting with the waist circumference and going on with the metabolic pattern in sense of improvement of triglyceride level, HDL cholesterol level, and fasting plasma glucose. What it was relevant in my point of view, it was also the parallel improvement in markers of systemic inflammation, like the level of high sensitivity CRP protein that is known to be strongly related not only with inflammatory diseases but also with the risk to develop cardiovascular disease. The global results of the study support the idea that the safe supplementation with symbiotic could have a global positive metabolic effect, and the main advantage of this approach is that it could be used also with the meaning to have also parallel positive effect on bowel health, and we know that elderly people have also often problem of regularity of bowel function. As well as improvement in other parameters, like for instance, immune function and general body health. Another relevant point of view that we have to consider is that this approach is not related to any kind of risk of a pharmacological interaction with the most commonly used drugs by elderly people.